So good morning everyone and welcome back once again to another session of PIB Current Affairs. In today's session, as usually, I will bring to you some more important questions from the PIB news which are relevant for all the government exams. Alright, so let's begin with the session. But before we begin guys, do subscribe to the channel if you are coming here for the first time and press this bell icon. You can also join this Telegram group. Here you will get the PDF of this session and also you can follow me here. Here also you can ask any doubt. So let's talk about the very first question. And remember, आज के जो session है बहुत छोटा होगा. आज की news में कोई बहुत ज़्यादा लंबी explanations नहीं है. There are very simple and direct news in today's session. So let's talk about the very first question, which says Niti Aayog in collaboration with Dash has developed geospatial energy map of India, which provides all the details of energy resources of the country. And this is, guys, a very good step by the Niti Aayog, because with the help of this geospatial energy map of India, one can easily identify the primary and secondary sources in the country. The person can identify the locations, the person can identify how much amount of resources is available in a particular area through this geospatial map of India. So let's talk about the news. So Niti Aayog, remember, has launched this geospatial map of India, which will provide all the details of energy resources in the country. And the map, it is based on 27 thematic layers. It will provide information regarding all the energy resources, whether it is conventional power plants, whether it is oil and gas wells, whether it is petroleum refineries, coal fields, coal blocks, district wise data on renewable energy, power plants, etc. So everything related to energy will be provided on this geospatial energy map of India. And also remember, this has been developed in collaboration with ISRO along with various energy ministries of the government of India, like Ministry of New and Renewable Energy, Ministry of Power, Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. So in sabhi ke collaboration ke saath, और इन सभी के सपोर्ट के साथ इन कोलैबोरेशन विद इसरो इट वाज डेवलप्ड बाय नीति आयोग. ऑलराइट, एंड दिस विल गाइस ऑफ कोर्स हेल्प अ पर्सन इन यू नो आइडेंटिफाइंग द एरियाज ऑफ इन्वेस्टमेंट वेयर द पर्सन कैन इजीली फाइंड द रिसोर्सेज ऑफ एनर्जी एंड देन दैट विल बी द प्लेस व्हिच प्लेस विल बी द गुड फॉर इन्वेस्टमेंट. सो बेसिकली इट विल हेल्प इन प्लानिंग एंड इन्वेस्टमेंट. ऑलराइट, एंड यू कैन सी हियर दिस मैप लुक्स लाइक दिस. तो इस तरीके का मैप है एंड ऑल द डिटेल्स रिगार्डिंग ऑल द नेचुरल ऑल द एनर्जी रिसोर्सेज आर गिवन एंड देयर इज अ वेबसाइट फॉर दिस. यू कैन नॉर्मली गूगल सर्च जियोस्पेशल एनर्जी मैप ऑफ इंडिया, यू विल बी डायरेक्टेड टू दिस वेबसाइट वेयर ऑल द जियोस्पेशल एनर्जी मैप्स आर अवेलेबल. सो दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस न्यूज एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. सो नीति आयोग इन कोलैबोरेशन विद इसरो हैज डेवलप्ड दिस. राइट, ऑप्शन सी इसरो इज द करेक्ट आंसर. ISRO chairperson is Mr. K. Sivan. Moving ahead to question number 2. In which district of Gujarat, Ayush 1, which is a dedicated forest for Ayurvedic plants, has been launched by Minister of Ayush. Now, who is the Minister of Ayush? It's Mr. Sarbanand Sonowal, who has been recently appointed to Rajya Sabha from Assam. He's a Rajya Sabha MP from Assam and he is also the Minister of Port, Shipping and Waterways. जो मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पोर्ट शिपिंग एंड वॉटरवेज है ये उसके भी मिनिस्टर है एंड ही इज ऑल्सो द मिनिस्टर ऑफ आयुष. सो सर्बानंद सोनोवाल हैज लॉन्च दिस आयुष वन इन गुजरात एंड आयुष वन इज रिमेंबर इज नथिंग बट द डेडिकेटेड फॉरेस्ट फॉर आयुर्वेदिक प्लांट्स. ये एक फॉरेस्ट है फॉर द आयुर्वेदिक प्लांट्स. सो बात कर लेते हैं इस न्यूज की, ज्यादा कुछ नहीं है इसमें वैसे. सो रिमेंबर दिस वॉज लॉन्च एज ए प्रोग्राम इन अ प्रोग्राम लॉन्च by Deen Dayal Port Trust and this has been launched at Gandhi Gram City. There is a city which is known as Gandhi Dham in Kutch district of Gujarat. ठीक है, कहाँ पे? Kutch district of Gujarat में इसको launch किया गया है. So here you have to remember 2-3 things. Number 1, where this Ayushvan has been launched, Gandhi Dham, Kutch district, Gujarat. ठीक है. Number 2, what is it? Ayushvan है क्या? It is a dedicated forest for medicinal plants, Ayurvedic plants. ठीक है. Number 2, and who launched it? मिनिस्टर ऑफ आयुष सर्बानंद सोनोवाल. दैट इज इट. इससे ज्यादा पढ़ने की कोई जरूरत नहीं है इस न्यूज में. सो दैट्स व्हाई द करेक्ट आंसर गाइस विल बी व्हाट? कच्छ. ऑप्शन ए कच्छ विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. And talking about Gujarat, so Gujarat's Chief Minister is Mr. Bhupendra Patel. He was recently appointed. Governor is Mr. Acharya Devrat. Acharya Devrat is the governor. Gujarat government recently launched e-Nagar mobile app. E-Nagar mobile app अभी हाल ही में launch हुआ था. And recently Thol Lake Wildlife Sanctuary and Vadhvana Wetland. Vadhvana Wetland have been included into the list of Ramsar site. And of course, the very next Defence Expo, which is in the year 2022, is going to be held in Gandhinagar. And Gandhinagar is also the headquarter of IFSCA, International Financial Services Centre Authority. Okay. So Kutch is the correct answer. Question number 3. With which of the following countries, administration of Jammu and Kashmir has signed an MOU for development of industries and other infrastructure? ठीक है, इंडस्ट्रीज एंड अदर इंफ्रास्ट्रक्चर को डेवलप करने के लिए कौन सी कंट्री के साथ जम्मू कश्मीर एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ने एक एमओयू साइन किया है? रिमेंबर हु इज द गवर्नर, हु इज द लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर? इट्स मिस्टर मनोज सिन्हा. मनोज सिन्हा. एंड हु इज द गवर्नर, लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर ऑफ लद्दाख? मिस्टर आर के माथुर. द वेरी फर्स्ट लेफ्टिनेंट गवर्नर ऑफ जम्मू एंड कश्मीर वॉज गिरीश चंद्र मुर्मू, हु इज नाउ द सीएजी ऑफ इंडिया. So this MOU has been signed between Jammu and Kashmir administration and government of Dubai. Dubai ke saath ye launch hua hai, and this has been signed with the objective of developing industries and various infrastructure in Jammu and Kashmir, like real estate development, industrial park, IT towers, multi-purpose towers, logistic, medical colleges, etc. Okay, and also remember, in the month of January 2021, the Union government had launched a central sector scheme for development of industries in Jammu and Kashmir, and for that they had allotted at that time rupees 28,400 crore. So us scheme ke under ye sare MOU ho rahe hain. Now everything related to industries and the infrastructure will be developed under this particular scheme only, which is a central sector scheme for Jammu and Kashmir. Now is scheme ke bare mein bhi thoda sa baat kar lete hain. So remember, the objective of the scheme is to develop, is the development of industries and thereby creating employment for the people, which will definitely boost the socio-economic conditions of the people of Jammu and Kashmir. The ministry which is implementing it is the Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal, and he is now also the Minister of Textiles, and he is also the leader in Rajya Sabha. Ye leader hai Rajya Sabha ke, leader of Rajya Sabha ye hai. And leader of opposition in Rajya Sabha is Mr. Khadge. Khadge ke pura naam bhul gaya main unka. Khadge Congress ke hain. He is the leader of opposition in Rajya Sabha. Leader in Mallikarjun Khadge. Yes, leader of Rajya Sabha is Mr. Piyush Goyal. Aur baat karte hain is scheme ke bare mein. So there are various type of incentive which will be provided to the beneficiaries. Number one is the capital investment incentive. ठीक है, पहली क्या है, कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट इंसेंटिव. सो द जोन्स आर डिवाइडेड, होल जम्मू एंड कश्मीर विल बी डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, आर डिवाइडेड इनटू टू पार्ट्स, जोन ए एंड जोन बी, एज पर द प्रोविजंस ऑफ द स्कीम. जोन ए आर द नियर बाय एरियाज, मतलब जो शहर के अंदर है, जो एक्सेसिबल एरियाज है, वाइल जोन बी आर द फार ऑफ एरियाज, लाइक पहाड़ों के अंदर कोई हार्ड टू रीच प्लेसेस हैं, दीज आर कैटेगराइज्ड एज जोन बी. ओके, तो 30% कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट इंसेंटिव इन जोन ए, 50% इन जोन बी. ठीक है, एंड दिस 30% एंड 50% इज ऑन इन्वेस्टमेंट मेड इन प्लांट एंड मशीनरी इन द मैन्युफैक्चरिंग सेक्टर और कंस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ बिल्डिंग एंड अदर ड्यूरेबल फिजिकल एसेट्स इन सर्विस सेक्टर. ठीक है, नंबर वन. नंबर टू, यूनिट्स विद एन इन्वेस्टमेंट ऑफ रुपीज 50 करोड़ आर एलिजिबल टू गेट दिस इंसेंटिव. ऑलराइट, and also maximum limit of incentive will be rupees 5 crore and 7.5 crore in the case of zone A and zone B respectively. So which means for zone A the maximum incentive that will be provided is 5 crores, while for zone B it is 7.5 crores. theek hai, iske alawa another incentive is the GST linked incentive, that is 300% of the eligible value of actual investment made in plant and machinery. Now what will be this eligible value, they have not declared this till now. Eligible value ke bare mein kuch khas jankari nahi hai. Of actual investment made in plant and machinery in the case of manufacturing sector, while construction in building and all other durable physical assets in the case of service sector. Okay. Now, the amount of incentive in a financial year will not exceed 1/10 of the total eligible amount of incentive. Total eligible amount जितना है उसका 1/10 से ज्यादा नहीं होना चाहिए of this component. Alright. Other incentive, capital interest subvention will also be provided at the annual rate of 6% for a maximum period of 7 years. ठीक है? On the loan up to rupees 500 crore for investment in plant and machinery in case of manufacturing sector and construction of building and other durable physical assets in services sector. Now number 4, working capital interest incentive is also provided, जो कि बहुत कम दिया जाता है. All existing units at the annual rate of 5% for a period of maximum 5 years, and under this component maximum incentive is how much? Rupees 1 crore. Okay, and total amount is 28,400 crores, the total outlay, and the scheme is intended to achieve its object by the financial year 2037. Okay, so let's come back to the question. Then the question is regarding the MOU Dubai. With Dubai, this MOU has been signed. So option B is the correct answer. Question number 4 pe chalte hain. Which of the following organizations will organize Aadhaar Hackathon 2021 from this to link innovation with Aadhaar services? See, Aadhaar services are already linked with innovation, but they want more innovation products into the services of Aadhaar. And for that, this Aadhaar Hackathon will be organized by UIDAI. UIDAI, Unique Identification Authority of India. And who is the CEO? Mr. Saurabh Garg. He was recently appointed, I guess in the month of March or April, he was appointed as the CEO of UIDAI, Saurabh Garg. Alright. Now this hackathon, guys, will be based on two themes. Ye yaad rakhna aapko, very important. Enrollment and update, and number 2 is identity and authentication. Enrollment and update, identity and authentication are the two themes, and this hackathon will be conducted by UIDAI, whose CEO is Mr. Saurabh Garg. Okay, itna hi padhna hai, isse zyada isme padhne ki koi zarurat nahi hai. So the correct answer will be what? Option E, UIDAI. Now let's move ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. Which of the following institutes under Ministry of Earth Science, headed by Dr. Jitendra Singh? He is also the Minister of Science and Technology. His Lok Sabha constituency is Udhampur in J&K. Has launched decision support system of air quality early warning system. So this air quality early warning system is already working in Delhi NCR to warn the authorities regarding the upcoming pollution. Agar koi kharab situation regarding to pollution aane wali hai. So this early warning system provide warning to the authorities 7 to 10 days before the onset of that particular bad thing. Agar koi kharab cheez aane wali hai, uske aane se 7 se 10 din pehle ye bata deta hai. Theek hai? But now one decision support system has also been developed by the Ministry of basically IITM Pune, and to make it more advanced, isko zyada advanced banane ke liye to baat karte hain. Chaliye, Ministry of Earth Sciences has launched decision support system of air quality early warning system, and this will extend the ability of the existing air quality early warning system, as I told you, by enabling it with the decision making capabilities. Now the air quality early warning system can now take the decisions as well with the help of decision support system. Now how is this possible? Let me explain you this, and this of course is for Delhi NCR region ke liye bhi hoga. First of all, do remember that it has been developed by IITM Pune, Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology Pune. And how it will enable the early warning system to take the decisions, because basically it is a numerical model based framework capable of identifying sources. Now what will be done is that it will first identify the sources. Okay, a threat is coming, so as per the threat there are various it is based on some kind of artificial intelligence. So ab isme hoga kya ki isme pehle se software hoga which will identify ki aisa karne pe hame kya karna chahiye. All right, let us say for example ki ye kehta hai ki एयर क्वालिटी इंडेक्स अगर 250 हो जाएगा देन ये वाला पर्टिकुलर एक्स वाई जेड स्टेप लेना है. सो इट विल डायरेक्टली टेल द अथॉरिटी कि नाउ यू हैव टू टेक दिस स्टेप. ओके एंड नाउ यू हैव टू टेक दिस स्टेप. सो दिस इज वाई, दिस इज हाउ इट विल हेल्प इन द डिसीजन मेकिंग बाय द अर्ली वार्निंग सिस्टम. ठीक है, मैं फिर से रिपीट कर देता हूँ. वट विल हैपन इज दैट लेट अस से एनी थ्रेट इज कमिंग रिगार्डिंग द पोल्यूशन एंड दिस डिवाइस, दिस डिसीजन सपोर्ट सिस्टम नोज दैट इन दिस कंडीशन वट इज टू बी डन and what is what needs to be done, it will tell the directly to the authority. ठीक है, this website, this system will directly tell the authority, okay, this needs to be done in this situation. So that way अब होगा क्या कि जो authority हैं उनको ये सोचना नहीं पड़ेगा कि अब हमें इस situation में क्या करना चाहिए. ठीक है, so basically the advice will be given by this system. All right, so this was about this news and therefore the correct answer will be what? Indian Institute of Tropical Meteorology, which is located in Pune. Option C is the correct answer. And that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you on Monday. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.